Hello and welcome to this week's Glasstire Top 5. It is the week of Thursday, December 12th, 2019. I'm Brandon Zech.
And I'm Christopher Blay.
And we are counting down the top 5 art exhibitions and shows and events and lectures and everything else in Texas.
All the things.
It's a really strong list this week.
Yeah, I think so. I agree with you.
Number 5 is actually a lecture that happens on Monday. This happens sometimes where things bleed over into what's technically next week, but this is a lecture with Gary Tintero. It's actually a conversation. It's a conversation with Gary Tintero and Michael Govan. So Gary Tintero, of course, the director of the Museum of Fine Arts Houston, and Michael Govan, the director of LACMA. I feel like if you've never been to LACMA, these two museums kind of parallel each other in a really interesting way. And their size, and they're both kind of focusing on expanding right now, and just having the two of them talk, I think, will actually be really interesting.
Number 4 is Lisa Krenichfeld at Fortworks Art. The show features works... there are drawings, collage, cyanotypes. She uses watercolor, resin. It's just a great amalgamation of techniques. Portraits of women that portray a sort of strength and almost aggression in the way she poses. But all the interiors are just really ornate. She uses Chinese paper in the background as well. It's very stylized, but she confronts the way women are traditionally portrayed in portraiture.
And it's also, a lot of the works deal with her coming from a Chinese family and growing up in the American South. Number 3 this week is a show of works by Hyde Fontenot called This and That and Such. This is at a relatively new San Antonio space that opened this year called Space C7 at Southside Living and Maker Spaces. So it is run by Jeff Wheeler of the Wheeler Brothers, longtime Texas fame. And this show is Hyde Fontenot, who is the Kasachuk artist in residence right now. So it's a show of his, a lot of his like nude figure drawings. Oh, and Hyde is always a beloved artist. He had a presence in San Antonio because he was an Art Pace resident, and then he started kind of doing this more experimental installation-like element of everything, and he's doing programming right now at Kasachuk too. So this is a great kind of homecoming, a little bit for San Antonio at least, and it's on view through the end of January.
Number 2 is the Berkeley-born Brooklyn artist Martin Gutierrez show at the Focus exhibition at the Modern Art Museum in Fort Worth. The show's been up for a while. We went to see it a couple of months ago, right after it opened. And we also did, Christina Reese, our editor-in-chief, did a podcast, which you can check out on Glasstire, that was in conversation with Allison Hurst, the curator of the exhibition. Most of the work is from the Indigenous Women publication that Gutierrez was the author, the interviewer, the publisher, the director. She did everything that is in the magazine. And the work is really slick photographs where she inserts herself into scenes. And she discusses ideas of race and gender in her work.
When we walked into the show, it seemed, I mean, the photographs are beautiful and they're very well done, but it was very much like, here are the photographs. And then once you turn around behind you, this is a little bit of a spoiler alert, but once you turn around behind you, it's kind of this photo mural that photographs are hung on top of, and it's so, I feel like that really kind of is the work. You know, framed photographs isn't necessarily the way that you're meant to experience this work.
Right.
And number 1 this week are 2 shows at the Art Museum of Southeast Texas, AMSET in Beaumont. They are opening on Friday. One show is Emily Peacock, Pure Comedy, and the other show is David McGee, Black Paintings. So Emily Peacock and David McGee, both kind of longtime Houston artists. David McGee farther in his career than Emily Peacock, a little older also. But this is just a continuance in the Art Museum of Southeast Texas, now under the curatorship of Mariah Rockefeller, doing shows and kind of big solo exhibitions, or sometimes first solo museum exhibitions, for really deserving Texas-based artists. I think this is Emily Peacock's kind of first big museum show. It's not David McGee's. At the same time, you've seen some of David McGee's work before. These paintings were in a show at Texas Gallery not too long ago. But really great paintings on his part, and I'm excited for some of the new series of works of Emily Peacock's that are in this exhibition.